crayfish dissection. After completing this video, you should be able to 1. Name the organs of the crayfish. 2. Identify the features that serve as adaptations for crayfish living in aquatic habitats. And 3. Demonstrate the correct procedure for dissecting a crayfish. To complete this lab, you'll need the following materials: personal protective equipment, dissection tools and pan, crayfish specimen, and camera for documenting your work. Before you begin, place a small but legible piece of paper with your name and the date of the dissection next to your specimen. Include this paper with any images taken of your specimen. Observe the external anatomy of your crayfish. Locate the head, cephalothorax, and abdomen. Observe the carapace, and then the ventral surface of the crayfish, as directed in the learning unit instructions. Begin the dissection by cutting up the exoskeleton from the tail to the eyes. Make sure your cuts are shallow, so as not to cut into internal organs. The scissors should be parallel to the exoskeleton. Hold the exoskeleton up and cut just underneath it with only the point of the scissors. Carefully detach the exoskeleton from the muscle attachment underneath. Gently pull the exoskeleton away. Once the carapace is removed, locate and observe the gills. Take a picture of the gills. Move the walking legs and notice how they are attached to the gills. This helps with respiration and serves to move water across the gills. Observe that there are lots of abdominal flexor muscles that can be viewed on the dorsal side flanking the intestine. Take a picture and label the abdominal flexor muscle. In between this muscle is the intestine, a long tube that runs along the abdomen to the stomach. Take a picture and label the intestine. Locate the heart, just underneath the carapace and positioned around the posterior portion of the cephalothorax. Take a picture and label the heart. The cream-colored structures beneath and slightly posterior to the heart are the gonads. Locate the stomach in the head region above the mouth. It's large, sac-like, and joins to the intestine. Remove the digestive glands, yellowish-green structures above the gonads, to view this. Take a picture and label the stomach. Locate the green antennal glands anterior to the stomach at the base of the antenna. These are primitive excretory organs that remove metabolic waste and excess water. Take a picture and label the green glands. The ventral nerve cord is a thin white thread similar to the spinal cord. Nerves fuse into the nerve cord at the posterior side of the brain. The nerve cord runs along the midline of the crayfish. The brain is found just anterior to the green glands. It's a small white mass between the eye stalks. In conclusion, you should have learned that the crayfish displays bilateral symmetry and a high degree of cephalization with its many sensory structures. The crayfish is well adapted for a life in an aquatic environment with its feathery gills. Its walking legs are attached in a way so as to move water over the gills when the organism is moving. The crayfish uses its legs, tail, and swimmerettes for locomotion and has a segmented body.